Today, I will use an ESP32 CAN board that costs around $5 to make a wireless live streaming camera that can be added natively and very easy in Home Assistant. I will show you every step that I did and I will share everything, so if you want, you can make one or dozen for yourself. I'm personally doing this as I want to set up one or two of such cameras in my basement, so I can monitor my analog water heater thermostat and my pellet burner directly in my Home Assistant dashboard. But the application of such tiny Wi-Fi cameras are endless, especially when you add Home Assistant in the whole picture, which will allow making ton of useful automations, as example video doorbells, image recognition, fish tank monitoring, and many more. I have to say that the image quality of the camera is not superb. It is far from the latest 8K security cameras out there, but it is decent enough, especially if you don't want to read books using the camera and you don't track fast objects. Before I continue to the needed things for the $5 live streaming camera for Home Assistant, I want to give you something digital for free. I hope it will be helpful, as it is a smart home glossary in a form of a PDF document that I made for you. Inside that glossary, I put all of the smart home related words and acronyms that I can think of, and their simple but useful explanations. So go to my website and download it right now, free of charge. Save it somewhere, and when you hear a smart home word or acronym that is not so clear for you, check the meaning in the glossary. Without further ado, let's start with the requirements for today's cheap live streaming camera for Home Assistant project. The first thing that is needed is the ESP32 CAN board and the tiny camera that is coming with it. You can find such in AliExpress website or in Amazon, and I will put some affiliate links in the video description if you want to check their current prices and eventually to buy some. Next thing that is needed is an FTDI adapter. I remember that this adapter was a bit scary to me at first, as it seems too complicated. But after the second time I use it, it all became fun. The adapter is so useful and cheap that I think that every IoT DIY guy should have one. The idea is the following. The ESP32 CAN board have no USB port, as well as many other IoT boards. Instead, these boards have pins. This means you can't easily connect these boards to your computer to flash them. Here comes the FTDI adapter, which have an USB to connect to your computer, as well as some pins to connect to your board. So it's kind of a good man in the middle. You only need this adapter during the flashing process. After that, you can put it in your drawer with your other IoT stuff until the next DIY project. Next, some jumper wires are also needed to connect the FTDI adapter to the ESP32 CAN, as well as an USB cable to connect the FTDI adapter to a computer, also an USB cable with USB adapter that will be used later to power the camera. Optionally, to make this $5 live streaming camera for Home Assistant to look cool and finished, you can buy a dummy or fake security camera case. Or you can print something from Thingiverse.com, for example, if you have a 3D printer. That was the needed hardware. Buying links for all parts can be found in the video description. Apart from the hardware stuff, you also need some software, namely Home Assistant and ESP Home Dashboard, where ESP Home Dashboard is available as Home Assistant add-on. To help you further with this software part, I will give you two things. First, if you want to know more about Home Assistant and the different installation types, or you still don't have Home Assistant, go register for my free webinar, where I'm explaining everything in details. And second, if you already have Home Assistant, but you don't have ESP Home Dashboard, check this video of mine where I'm explaining the possible ways to get it. Check these two things now and then come back right here. If you already have them, just continue watching, as now is the best time to connect the ESP32 CAN board to the FTDI adapter. One important remark here, most FTDI adapters have a jumper that can switch between 3 volts and 5 volts. For this project, the FTDI adapter should be set to 5 volts. After I switch to 5 volts, I will use 5 female to female jumper wires and I will connect the ground pin of the FTDI adapter to any of the ground pin on the ESP32 CAN board. Then I will connect the RX pin on the FTDI adapter to the UOT pin of the ESP32 CAN, TX on the FTDI to the UOR, and VCC or power on the FTDI to the 5 volt pin on the ESP32 CAN. To put the ESP32 CAN into programming or flashing mode, I have to connect any of the ground pins on the ESP32 CAN board to the IO0 pin, again on the ESP32 CAN. This last connection is only needed during the flashing process and can be removed after that. This is the end result of how I connect everything. After I have that, I'll connect the FTDI adapter to the computer where Home Assistant and ESP Home dashboard is installed, so I can flash the ESP Home firmware on the ESP32 CAN. Here is how. Inside Home Assistant, I'll open my ESP Home dashboard and I'll add a new device. I'll click continue here. The name of the device will be ESP32 CAN. I'll enter my wireless network name and password. Then I'll click next. As device type, I'll select ESP32 and I'll click next. The configuration is now created and I can install it, but I'll skip that because I want to edit the configuration. I'll click on the edit button. I'll select everything here and I'll delete it. Then I'll paste my own configuration, which is adding all of the needed stuff that I want. You can get this configuration from the video description, so don't try to remember it. This is the ESP Home section. I'm enabling the logger. I'm also enabling the Home Assistant API, over-the-air updates. Web server will be also available for this device. These are my Wi-Fi credentials. AP fallback hotspot, captive portal is enabled, and this is the ESP32 camera configuration. I'm also configuring the flashlight as a switch here, because the ESP32 CAN board have a little LED that can be used as a flash. I'll save this configuration and I'll hit install. But before I hit install, I'll connect my ESP32 CAN board to the FTDI adapter, and then I will connect my FTDI adapter to the device where Home Assistant is installed and where the ESP Home dashboard is. In my case, this is a Raspberry Pi 4. So I'm ready with the wired connection and I'll just hit install. From this dialog, I'll select this third option, plug into computer running ESP Home dashboard, because as I said, this is what I'm using. I'll click on it. I'll select my FTDI adapter here and the installation process begin. Some libraries will be downloaded and some compilation will be performed. But don't worry, everything will happen automatically for you. And I think I'm ready. Now I have to remove the ground to IO0 wire and I have to restart my board. I'll close this. I'll close this as well. Currently, the ESP32 CAN is offline. I can see the logs wirelessly. I have some warnings. But this is what I wanted to see. Got image and some length. I'll close this. My device is already online. That means I can try to add it to my Home Assistant. For that, I'll go to the overview section. I'll press the C button. And I'll start typing integrations. Then I'll navigate to integrations. Let me search for the device. it is quite possible your device to be auto-discovered by Home Assistant, but for some reason this is not the case here, and I'll add it manually. I'll hit Add Integration, I'll search for ESP Home, I'll select here No Setup on Other Instance of ESP Home, and I'll type ESP32CAM.local. Or the IP of the device that can be found in the logs, the port will stay as it is, and I'll click Submit. And success! My device is added to Home Assistant. I just have to click Finish. And where is my device? Here it is. One device with two entities. I have flashlight and my cam. If I click on this, the flashlight will be turned on. I'll show you. If I turn it off, the LED is also turned off. Everything is working. Let's see the cam. I'll turn off the flashlight. Now it's better without flashlight. This flashlight is quite strong, I must say. Let me try to turn this around. I'm not sure which side is up. Nevertheless, I can add this to my dashboard. This is how my cart will look like. Add to dashboard. And now, if I go to the dashboard, I'll see the live stream. Here it is. Hello. It is working. Very good. I can show you my phone to see if the image is readable. I think it is. Of course, there is some lagging, but that's quite normal for a chip that costs around $5. As I said in the beginning, the final step is to power the ESP32 CAM and to leave it somewhere with a Wi-Fi coverage. To power the ESP32 CAM, I have two options. To buy a module or head with USB, you can find such in the video description, or I can cut a USB cable and I can connect the red wire to the 5V pin of the ESP32 CAM and the black USB wire to the ground pin. Optionally, you can buy a fake security camera case and put your ESP32 CAM inside. I have a quick challenge for you. Are you going to try this $5 live streaming camera for Home Assistant, and for what are you going to use it? Share your answers in the comment section below. Also, if you manage to do it, type hashtag ESP32CAM owned, so everybody will know that you made it and can congratulate you. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!